I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
Pull back. He knocked the mid off the. That would be. Mikey, do you think Adrian Broner will respect you?
We know Broner. We know Adrian. He's a character. He promotes the fights.
The next question for Mikey. Will you move back to 140 after Broner fight, or is 140 permanent? Would you move, I mean...
No, I would like to come down to 35 for a unification match or a good title defense. Before staying at 140 permanently, but we'll just wait and see, you know, play by ear, see how things go and how I feel later in the year and what else is available too, if the right fights are actually available.
Next question, Broner is very strong. How do you handle his strength?
We gotta be careful. We gotta be aware of that. Can't get sloppy. I'm not gonna be able to, you know, sleep on it. I gotta be careful.
If Adrian Broner loses, would you let him train with you?
Robert, I don't think Robert would.
Why not?
I don't know. Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah, maybe.
How much does a non-superstar amateur who becomes a pro...
Like Billy Dib says, if you can't beat them, you got to join them. Right?
So that'll be Joe Goosen beat Diego Corrales, or Diego Corrales came to train with him, right?
He'd be...
Soto Casamayor, right?
He'd be 0-2 against me, so if you can't beat him, join him. Just like Billy Dib said.
Robert, how much does a kid who turns pro, who's not a superstar amateur, make in a four-round fight?
Is that a superstar amateur? $1,000. You go to Mexico, 150.
150 bucks?
Oh, even less.
Wow. There's no money.
But 1,000. Some get 800. 800, like in club shows like that. 800, 1,000. Depending on how many tickets you sell. Some kids sell a lot of tickets, so they get a percentage on every ticket they sell, so they could make an extra $300-$400.
That's not a lot.
From their 1,000 purse. But if they're signed...
Dude, I just got all the messages right now.
If they're good amateurs and signed with a good promoter, then probably should be like 4,000, like 1,000 per round.
Wow, that's pretty good. That's better.
And stuff like...
Robert, how old does someone have to be to train at your gym? Or you don't really train kids here?
We don't train kids anymore.
But if you did train kids, what was the...
Our
8, 7?
Well, when we used to train kids, we had kids at, you know, at 6 years old.
Five, six.
Who is better, Canelo or Juan Manuel Marquez?
Skills-wise?
Marquez is better.
Skills-wise, Marquez, man.
In what ways does Canelo is better than Marquez?
Only in popularity. In popularity and money he's making and all that, yes.
But
in skills, fighter, I think Marquez is
more accomplished, too.
Is not even close.
What does the big G say?
¿Quién era mejor peleador? ¿Quién es mejor peleador en su puesto? ¿Márquez o Canelo? Entre los dos.
¿Márquez? Your mom said...
Era de un talento muy bueno. Canelo también era. ¿Canelo? Yo creo que Márquez era.
Yo dije que no.
Márquez,
sí. Y ahorita Canelo está también recibiendo, pero Márquez no lo cuidaron así.
Márquez was a very good fighter. Now Canelo's looking very good, and I mean, he's still in his career, so who knows what he can accomplish too. But I think Márquez was a better fighter.
Márquez has one fight left. Would you want him, Mikey, to...
You know what?
One fight, isn't it two? Because he's fighting in July.
Oh, yeah, two now,
but then... fighting.
He says he's got two fights.
And then in December.
He's fighting a big one.
Maybe Cotto.
Cotto, a tough fight with Kama guy. I think he wins, but it's a tough fight.
But then December was with Márquez. I've heard.
Yeah. Who wins that one?
I think Cotto's too big for Márquez.
Márquez owes me 300 bucks. That's what I know. I bet him on camera about Errol Spence against... he was so confident Kell Brook would win. So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekpak.